Oh man, two worrying signs in the Bitcoin chart that we could be heading for a meaningful pullback here on Bitcoin. Are you prepared or are you gonna get shaken out? Here on the Bitcoin chart, guys, you can see we are forming an ascending broadening wedge. I'm gonna explain why this could be a little bit of a worrying pattern, but I've also seen something bullish which we need to come on to as well. Smash up the likes, don't forget to subscribe, as always check out the links in the description if you want to trade with us. Our VIP community, ejazda.uk/TG, are making insane results, guys. Just jump into our Telegram and look at some of the trading results people are achieving, because people are literally changing their lives through crypto trading, and this is your opportunity to do the same. We're here on this ascending broadening wedge. Now, and you know, at first glance, this is an innocent pattern, right? Where we're managing to consolidate here to the upward side, and you'd be forgiven for thinking that, oh no, this is good. Bitcoin's not cooling off. We're grinding higher. We're sitting at 37,000. But there's something a little bit more important going on in the charts, which we have to focus on. And the first one is, what is the technical characteristic of this type of pattern, right? Where do these typically go? Well, if you take a look here, this is the case one formation. And an ascending broadening wedge defined by how you first enter the pattern. So we entered this pattern in bullish momentum. And again, guys, if you want to learn all of this in a structured curriculum, I go through this, ejazda.uk/TA. You could have learned all of this and spotted this before I make this video. But we came into this pattern from a bullish perspective, as opposed to coming in from a bearish retracement. We've come in bullish, and then we've been ascending in this ascending broadening wedge. And we've been creating higher lows, and we've been creating higher highs, right? Exactly what we've got here in the chart, on the live chart. Higher lows grinding to the upside, and higher highs here to the upside. But what do you notice? 80% of the time, this exit is bearish. Yes, bearish breakdown from this type of pattern. In 75% of the cases, an ascending broadening wedge is a reversal pattern. So in this case, we've been bullish. Is it a sign of a reversal to the downside? And in 60% of cases, an ascending broadening wedge's price objective is achieved when the support line is broken. Remember, the support line is this line here, right? And the price objective is to fall to the bottom of the wedge. So if we come back to Bitcoin, what could that possibly mean for us? Well, if we lose this support, which, by the way, guys, look at this support. This support sits here, right? Which is also a test of the horizontal support at 36.1. So that's going to be a really important level for us. If we lose that 36.1 level here on Bitcoin, we break down, maybe we retest like that, then the price target from the technical breakout and the reversal is the bottom of the wedge, which sits here, right? Back in this level, which, if you want to give it a number, is around that 33.4K level at the bottom of the wedge. So you guys have to be realistic. You have to be looking for some of these levels in the charts instead of saying, yeah, this is so fun, we're just moving higher and higher and higher. Now, of course, technical analysis comes with its weaknesses. We know that, of course, the remaining 20% of the cases, so 1 in 5 times, this can indeed break to the upside. But what it allows us to do is be prepared. What it allows us to do is say, okay, we're in the middle of the pattern here, and if we start spending more time to the bottom here, I'm going to get worried that we could be breaking down. But if we start spending more time to the upside here, maybe we can be that 1 in 5 case where we just have so much bullish intent that we're going to break to the upside and continue our movement to the upside. So that's one thing I wanted to share with you guys. Now, the other glaringly obvious thing which I want you guys to look at is something known as an RSI divergence, and in this case, it's a bearish divergence. Again, guys, we go for all of this. ejazda.uk/TA. You have no reason to not know this stuff heading into a bull market. I've been sharing this data with you guys for many, many years now. It's been years I've been making this content. So definitely do yourself a favor and go check this out, so you are on top of the news and not reacting to it. And what I want to share with you is this. Let's take a line here and let's apply this line down here to the downside. We have a downward trend. We have lower highs here on RSI, and yet higher highs and higher lows, an uptrend on price action. This is your classic divergence. Price moving in one direction, the RSI, which shows you if something is overbought or oversold, is moving in the other direction. Now, what this statistically means is when you see divergence, it normally means that the price is exhausted, it's unlikely to move to the upside, and more likely to go sideways if not downwards. So your options here are sideways, and we know from the pattern we were just sharing before, which is your ascending broadening wedge, that this is saying we could 80% of the time break to the downside. So now we have something called confluence, where we have more than one indicator or a data point telling us the same story. And as a technical analysis trader, as a crypto trader, if you're able to marry those up, if you're able to get a handful of different indicators telling you the same story, you are increasing the probability that your next trade is going to be correct. So for me, I'm looking here, I'm going, okay, it would be silly and irrational of me, given the fact that this is an ascending broadening wedge, which is a bearish pattern, given the fact that I'm seeing clear divergence here on the 4-hourly chart, to set myself crazy price targets that we're just going to break through 38, 39, and 40. Now, what is our job on top of that? Our job on top of that is then to marry on the fundamentals or the macroeconomics as well. And we know one of the most important things we're looking at right now is this market going to see an interest rate pause? And you can see something really, really interesting has just happened. It's ever so minute, but it's really important, okay? When we logged into this on Friday, we saw that 100% of the market had priced in that we were going to get a pause, that Jerome Powell and the Fed would not use the optionality that they kept in terms of using one more rate hike of 25 basis points. But today you saw something really interesting. 0.2%, a tiny bit of the market, has just opened up the bets that we could be getting a rate cut, which is incredible. I personally don't think we're getting a rate cut. More likely than not, we're going to get a pause on the 13th of December, which is fast approaching now, the last FOMC meeting of this calendar year. But it's interesting to see that markets are already starting to knock on the door to say, hey, Jerome Powell, any chance of a cut? Cheeky cut, mate, cheeky cut, right? So, and that's going to be the narrative going into next year. And if that narrative continues and that noise becomes louder and louder, and if CPI continues to improve like it did last week, if PPI continues to improve like it did last week, we can start to picture an environment where risk is strongly rotating on. And that's what's also important today. Yes, we're seeing Bitcoin fall here slightly today, but the dollar index is not having a crazy day either. It's flat. And more importantly, if you look at the dollar index, and I bring out the EMA ribbon, which is our trusted tool here, it's lost its 200 exponential moving average, right? So it's lost its EMA ribbon. It's lost the 200 period exponential moving average. If we come onto the weekly chart, it's lost its weekly EMA ribbon as well. And this is hugely positive here for Bitcoin and risk on assets. This is really good. And if we can follow up this week with another red week for Bitcoin, showing that risk is rotating on, the Nasdaq does well, Bitcoin does well, altcoins do well, we can start sending this here. And the true breakthrough is, can we set a new lower low here for the dollar index? Last time we came all the way to this level, the 200 moving average, the teal colored line here, and it bounced with vengeance. It said, hang on a second, no, we're bouncing. This time, can we send it back down here and send it for a big retracement? Because that's ultimately what we need. If you go back into previous cycles, it's when the dollar index continues here down this path here that Bitcoin continues to do well. Now, if we then zoom out to Bitcoin, how are we doing here on Bitcoin? Well, like I just shared with you, on the daily and the 4-hourly chart, you could make an argument for a pullback. But look at this on the weekly chart. Does that pullback really matter? I said to you, looking at that chart pattern, that a pullback could be down to 33.3. That's about here on the chart. So if you pull back on the weekly down to here, you've still got all this space down towards your EMA ribbon. It's insane how much room Bitcoin has to call off here. Could even come down here to 32, retest these areas where it got rejected months previously, right, before finally breaking through it and pushing onwards. Come back here, retest 32, and things are still healthy here on the Bitcoin price as far as the weekly time frame is concerned. On the daily time frame, you can see we're riding our EMA ribbon currently. It's a very strong EMA ribbon. It's a very extended EMA ribbon. But even pulling down to that 33 level is nothing but a retest of the EMA ribbon. That's all it is. It'd all just lead to a retest here, and then you'd hope for a nice strong bounce and response for Bitcoin before then heading to battle through 40,000 and beyond. So we look at the chart, we see instant levels where, you know, there is reason to expect a pullback and to be prepared. I'll personally keep some funds on the sideline waiting for those levels. If we get down to that bottom of the wedge at that 33.5k level, even a bit before they're at 34, I'll start nibbling, I'll start DCAing, I'll start picking up some more purchases of Bitcoin, Ethereum, and some of my favorite altcoins. Because right now, when this market is so overextended on these green candles, that's not when I want to be doing my buying. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video. If you do, smash the likes. Don't forget to subscribe. Make sure you're trading with us, Ijaz.UK/TG. Our community is absolutely smashing it every single day. They're sending me screenshots of their amazing results they're achieving, and you guys could be doing that too. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.